teams, seven rounds, 224 young men who today are about to become players in the National Football League. A day where lives are changed, fates are decided, dynasties are born, and the clock is always ticking. Of course, I'm talking about draft day.
That's right away the top pick. Callahan could be huge.
That's true.
But it might be worth it if someone's willing to give us their weight in gold to get him. What did the Rams get when they traded away number two overall to the Redskins a few years back?
Three number one picks and a number two.
Well, shit, that'd work for me.
Nobody's offering us that, Walt. Look, you want the entire city of Seattle calling for our heads because we didn't pick Bo Callahan?
Our fans know a good deal when they see one, Tom. Which is why we're not even going to think about doing this unless we can find someone
stupid enough to get us more than you should.
Exactly. So, who's the most desperate guy you know?
Entered the draft since Andrew Luck.
All right, so you get the Heisman Trophy winner going to the Seahawks. But what about the other 31 teams? What are they going to do? Who are you looking at today, John?
Mel, I think it's Cleveland at number 7. Sonny Weaver Jr., he's got to have a lot on his mind this year.
I'm with Mel. As we all know, Sonny's dad, former Browns coach Sonny Weaver Sr., he's a legend in Cleveland. He died last week.
This kid, Ray Jennings, Heisman Trophy finalist his senior year. 2,159 combined yards, running the ball, catching the ball, 22 touchdowns. He's looking to take it to the house. The only downfall is this guy got into a little skirmish, assault his battery, landed the kid in the hospital, but guess what? He was a model citizen up until then.
And you guys know me, I'm all about value. And this kid's number 2 on my board. And when I look at that incident, I kind of say, look, it's not medical.
Good morning.
It's not drug related. Right. So if I got a kid at number 2, and he slides down towards number 7,
you look nice.
You gonna say anything to me? Anything at all?
Well, it's big. It's a pretty big thing we're talking about here. Look, you can understand why this week of all weeks I might feel just a little conflicted about that, because I'm suddenly gonna be a dad.
I know. Shit timing.
Place
before work.
I'm out. Hey, Tom. You're up early.
Well, it's draft day. How you doing?
Well, I'm great.
great. I'm having a great day. How about you?
Well, I'm sitting here eating my pancakes. Thinking about moving number one.
Really?
Yeah, as you know, Connor did a great job for us last year.
But
Callahan looks like, well, hell, Sonny, he's going to be a franchise player for some.
You'd consider a trade? I'd consider the right one. Well, Jesus, Tom, at least act like you called me. All right? What do you want for it?
I want your first pick this year, your first rounder next year, and your third rounder the year after that.
Ouch. Ouch. No thanks.
I know what it sounds.
Sounds like you're trying to take advantage of me.
I would never do that. Your seventh pick gets you one. A running back with a rap sheet?
You don't know who I'm picking, seven, Tom. I'm not going to sell the farm for one guy.
Well, you should. Your farm sucks. Pick number one. Get Bo Kelly.
I got a quarterback.
Brian Drew? You talking about Brian Drew? Jesus, you're hilarious. Guy barely made it through half the season before getting injured last year. I have the golden ticket, Sonny. If I give it to you, you get to save football in Cleveland. You have 10 seconds, then I gotta go to work.
Enjoy your pancakes, Tom.
Folks, I believe the word Clevelander comes from the Latin word that means to have idiotic hope at all time and don't we ever. We don't have beaches and beautiful weather and sunshine and hot babes roller skating all over. You know what we got? We got our sports teams. And that's the only hope we have. Let me explain to you. Football was invented 20 miles down the road in Canton, Ohio. This is a football town. It's in our DNA.
No doubt about it. To me, losing the team altogether, having the team go and move to Baltimore, go there and win, that was so painful for the town. And then the new expansion franchise having to come back in. One of the amazing things to me is that in the midst of all of this losing, people are still hopeful that eventually this is going to be our year.
Yeah. Maybe to a fault with the hope, but that's really all we have because this is a sports town.
And I want Sonny Weaver to know.
Sonny, I hope you're listening. You better be. Can you please do something tonight to turn this thing around? Otherwise, you will be gone.
Hello?
Good morning, Mr. Sonny Weaver Jr. It's your number one fan, Vontae Mack.
Vontae, how'd you get this number?
You gave it to me. At the combine? Sorry if I called it.
That's all right. It doesn't matter. Vontae, the draft doesn't start until late. Where are you, New York?
No, man. They wanted me up there, Radio City, but wanted to be here in Virginia with Grams. She knows she can't make that trip. So? Who you picking? Fires you, I take a lightning quick middle linebacker to convert the gaps into 3-4.
Totally agree. You got Reggie Wilson's number down there in Purdue?
You know, I really don't find that funny.
It is funny, Vontae. You're just not feeling it right now. Look, there's going to be a lot of ups and downs before this is all over. Try and keep a sense of humor.
I ain't stupid. You don't take me at 7, I drop down to the late teens. Watch the mock drafts. I know who's taking who, and I can't afford to fall that far. Can't take no late teens paycheck. Vontae, he's a 7-pick paycheck.
Got a gaggle of nephews need to get fed now.
Taking them tumbling. Nephews, you love tumbling, yes or no?
See, that's the difference between them and me. I do not like tumbling, especially if I'm tumbling 13 picks. Feel me? 7-pick makes
me. So I appreciate that, Vontae. I really do. Say, but I gotta go.
17 or 18.
Then I got tech. Y'all ready to go?
Yes.
Y'all ready to tumble?
Yes.
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 That's what I want.
Hello?
Sonny, Earl Jennings. Hey, Earl, you with your boy today?
Yeah.
You guys in the Big Apple?
Listen, Sonny.
It's none of my business who you drive today.
All right, Ray will play for whoever wants him. But if you're thinking of picking him, I need you to know that I raised Ray right.
Come on, Earl. I know what the papers say.
I'll have him explain it to you.
What's going on, Mr. Weaver? First of all,
I'm not in the gang. But the guys that were with me, I grew up with them. I've known them since I was a kid. But the dudes we ran into, you know, they were big dudes. And they came at us. What were we supposed to do? Just stand up?
Well, they say you whooped on that kid pretty good, right? He's still in the hospital.
He's not a kid.
None of them were. They were grown men. They should have known better, Mr. Weaver.
Well, that's not the point. Did you hurt your hands?
You need your hands, right?
I know. I just lost my head.
Did you find it?
Yes, sir.
Well, good. Now, hold on to it. Understand me?
Yes, sir.
Enjoy the day, Ray. You only get drafted once.
Yes, sir, I appreciate that, Mr. Weaver.
That's the way it works.
I know. Just nervous, man.
You see that? That's the dungeon drop. Kids waited an hour to take it. It's exactly 50 feet from the end of the slide right into the pool. Huge splash. Anybody within shouting distance would have gotten completely soaked. And people pay for that. I need you to make a splash, Sonny. We need to sell tickets.
Well, I'm trying to help you do that, Anthony, in my own way.
You can't help me by making a splash. If you can't do it, then I have to do it, and I don't want to have to do that, Sonny.
Just to be clear here, you're threatening to fire me, right?
Let's talk about the draft. What do we need? I hear a quarterback is a good thing to have.
We have Brian Drew. Oh.
Word on Drew is that he's weak in the knees. That's what I heard.
Well, that's because you heard it from me.
We were 6-10
last season. 5-1 until Drew went down.
And he went down because he's weak in the knees.
There's not a quarterback in this draft after Callahan that can make a difference to our team. Right? We're way too far down to get him.
Okay, what else? Our shiny new head coach wants a shiny new running back. Ray Jennings. He's Cleveland royalty.
I know what Penn wants. Come on, Anthony. He says he would stay out of this.
Coach Penn has a Super Bowl ring. He used to coach the
He college. Took over for a team that won the Super Bowl and then proceeded to run it into the ground. Got himself fired, lucky for us.
The Cowboys really have great helmets.
Well, Anthony, you're the owner. You can change the helmets if you want. Look, you just got to let me do my job. I mean, I like Bonte Mack. He's special. He's different. He can transform our defense, even as a rookie.
Defense doesn't make a splash. Sonny. People pay to get wet.
Shameful. You're almost glad Coach Weaver isn't around to watch his son run this team into the ground.
I mean, Tom, listen. This guy comes 2 years after supposedly saving San Francisco and general manages us right to a losing season. Then you follow that up the next season by firing his own father. Coach Weaver, rest his soul, Tom, he was football.
Have you tried everyone?
Everyone worth asking. Far, no one's willing to overpay. Shit. I really thought I could get Sonny Weaver to bite. I mean, he just lost his old man.
Lisa.
Sonny, how can I help you?
Okay, I'm ready to do this, Tom. Our next two number one picks, third rounder for your pick today.
Correction, your next three first round picks.
What?
You heard me.
You want me to give you the Cleveland Browns first round picks for the next 3 years?
That's right.
Well, that's insane.
Tom, that wasn't your offer.
Well, I changed my offer. And we lived in a different world than we did a couple hours ago. I made you a fair offer, and you told me to enjoy my benefits.
You think I'm going to give you my next 3 number one picks?
That ain't so.
I'm not paying you.
Next 3 first round picks.
Everybody's dropped back deep. The safeties are halfway to Abilene thinking they got this thing iced. Everybody and their mother, hell, their grandmothers, think it's going to be the deep ball, right? The long bomb, the Hail Mary. Instead, it's a toss out to my man, Ray Jennings. And boom, he gets swallowed up by this huge, ugly nose tackle. The hee-haw or maho-haw. One of those huge Samoan kids, right? And when he looks down, guess what he sees? Nothing, because Ray ain't there. You know where Ray is? He teleported 6 feet to the left, and he's off to the races. Every poor Sooner bastard on the field is soiling his pampers trying to get to him. What does Ray do? He brings it back. He cuts, shimmy, shake and bake, and hurdles over Kyle Danforth. All-American Kyle Danforth. And he's ghost. 67 yards, touchdown, ball game. I'm telling you guys, Ray's dad was a special player for the Browns, but this kid might be even better. Morning, Sonny.
Morning, sir.
Morning.
Hey, Sonny, guys.
Just telling Jelly Donut, the guys here, my favorite Ray Jennings story, because they're telling me we have not yet decided. I mean, we're not seriously considering anybody else, right?
What are you doing, Sonny?
Just made a trade with the Seahawks.
For?
The number one pick. Oh, appears that way. Al, are you here?
Yes.
Is this going to screw us up with the salary cap?
Moving from 7-1. About another $1.5 million we weren't anticipating for this year, maybe an extra $5.5 million in signing bonus.
You have that?
We can make it work. Let me get into it.
Pretty good news, huh? Yeah. Number one pick. Yeah.
Had a QB. Tell me, what did we give up?
A number one pick this year.
And?
First round pick next year.
Okay, well that's a lot, but you get a chance to clear like Callahan.
And the year after that.
You gave up 3 consecutive first rounders.
Sonny, that's our future.
No. Well, Callahan's our future.
$30 million, Sonny.
Excuse me?
$30 million. That's what you're paying me to coach this team for the next 6 years. Did it cross your mind? Did you think it might be maybe important to discuss this decision with me first?
No. It's my call. As you can infer from Coach Penn's reaction, I just put all our asses on the line. The kid, I think we all agree, is pretty good. Until about 10 minutes ago, I don't think any of us thought this was possible, and I seriously doubt that we have looked at him the way we might have. That's my fault. All right, guys, that's on me. Now that's changed. So if we go ahead with this, if we pick him and find out tomorrow that he has got knee problems, he's got bedwetting problems, or he's got goddamn OCD, we're all going to be fired. What's beeping?
Hello?
Am I on the big phone?
Yes, Anthony, you're on the big phone.
And can everybody hear me? Sonny, I'd like to congratulate you. I asked you to make a splash, and you did. Is everybody still there? Anthony, how do you already know about this?
can I tell you, my boy? It's good to be the owner. I'm about to board my plane. I'm heading for New York.
You're going to the draft?
No, I'm going to see Spider-Man turn off the dark. Of course I'm going to the draft. We got Bo Callahan. Is that it?
Yes, sir.
Good.
Anthony?
Sonny, my assistant Heather just arrived from the equipment manager. I had a jersey made up for the young man. I'm going to hand it to him myself personally when his name is announced. Bo Callahan's going to be the son I never had.
Anthony, you already have a son.
Sonny, nice work.
Well, is that settled?
Yeah, it may be. We're still going to have to take another look at this kid and everything there is to know about him before I can feel good about what we just risked.
Meaning all of our jobs.
Yes, I do understand how important it is, but Mr. Weaver is not here right now, so the best I can do is I can make a message.
Allie?
Oh, you know what? He actually just walked in. Can you hold for one moment?
Where's Allie?
I don't know where Allie is.
She's not in her office. Allie!
I'm right here.
What's he doing here?
This is Rick. He's a new intern.
Yeah, we've met before, actually.
He'll be helping you today because Rona got mono. And I need Keith and Jeremy for salary cap troubleshooting.
I have Adam Schefter from ESPN on the line. He heard a rumor.
Oh, right. Tell Schefter to stick his rumor up.
Sonny.
All right, then, tell him I'm not taking any media calls right now.
Yes, sir. And what kind of soda?
I don't want a goddamn soda, Rich.
Thank you, Rick.
Listen, I know you're mad.
I'm not mad.
And I'm sorry about the things.
I'm not mad. I understand the situation. Whatever it is that you and I have, you've been very clear that it wasn't.
Wait, what are you talking about clear? I haven't been clear about anything.
Well, maybe that's the problem. So, what did you have to give up for the number one pick?
The first round pick for the next 3 years.
Wow.
Yeah, wow.
Get your head out of your ass.
What's going on?
Who the hell is this
moron? This is our new intern, Rick. What do you want?
I need every tape of Callahan like yesterday. And suddenly every tape of everyone is AWOL. And shit show Johnny over here doesn't have a goddamn clue where they are.
Game tape is in the archives. Chill out.
Chill out? They changed the punch code.
Okay, I will get it, okay? I will get the Callahan tapes, for Christ's sakes. Just deal with the call and handle lunch orders. Don't ever speak to an intern like that again. Go back in the war room. Your tapes will be here shortly.
Mr. Weaver?
What?
Chris Crawford is on line 3.
Crawford.
How's my favorite super agent?
Well, I'm living a dream, Sonny Weed. Dreaming of a magical wonderland called Cleveland, where my golden arm quarterback is going to make all your dreams come true. Yeah, how is my favorite Badger?
Well, he's doing great. He's excited. You know, Bo loves Coach Penn.
He loves the dog pound. And did I mention that Bo loves playing in the cold weather? Because Bo loves playing in the cold weather. We both know it's cold in Cleveland.
I'd love to talk with him, Chris.
He's right here. Hold on.
Sonny Weed, see?
How are you, Mr. Weaver?
I'm doing fine. How are you, son? Excited?
Well, of course I am. It's an exciting day. I can't lie.
Good, good. Well, try and enjoy this part of it if you can. You only,
get drafted once.
Well, thank you very much, sir. I appreciate that.
Got a question for you, Bo.
Anything, Mr. Weaver. Fire away.
How important is winning to you?
Excuse me?
Well, I've seen all the tape on you and talked to everyone that matters, but that's the thing I still don't know.
How important is winning to you?
Well, winning is everything, sir.
Everyone says that, Bo.
I suppose they do, sir.
Look, I don't know what else to tell you. Winning is the only thing that matters to me.
Oh, and by the way, I'd like to offer my condolences for your father.
Thanks,
Bo. Thanks for saying that. Thank Chris for me. Talk to you later, pal.
Okay. Thank you, Mr. Reaver. I look forward to meeting you, sir.
Great job.
It's all right.
Cleveland.
Thank you.
Allie? Mom?
You sold a cow for magic beans.
What?
You could have stole Ray Jennings at 7.
How does the entire world already know about this, Mom?
Because Monty Mac just tweeted it.
He tweeted it?
Yeah. Here. Agent just called. Brown's trade for number 1.
Sorry, Cleve. You get both. No Monty. Dumb move.
You're on Twitter?
You're not.
I'm sorry, Sonny. Is this a bad time?
I gotta go, Mom.
This is the draft analysis we've all been working on for the last 2 months.
Can we get you gentlemen some coffee?
Love, son.
Light and sweet, honey. Thanks.
Yeah, I'm not getting you idiots anything.
I like her. I'm a salary cat. She's a sweetheart.
Yeah, she's the best.
Why am I here, Sonny?
Because Melina thinks she coached the Cowboys.
I did coach the Cowboys.
And I think you were a bad babysitter.
You know, my wife loved living in Dallas, Sonny. It's a rich town full of fancy people, and she likes that kind of thing. So she wasn't exactly thrilled when I said, hey, baby, pack your bags. We're moving to Cleveland.
Well, there's fancy people here, too.
No, there's really not, which is okay by me. But I dragged my pretty wife to this town because this city deserves a championship, and I'm the guy that can deliver it.
Well, then we're on the same page, Vance.
Oh, yeah? And keep me in the loop.
There is no loop, all right? There's me doing my job, you doing yours. Your job is to coach a team I give you. They do it different in Dallas?
Yeah, they do. They win. A lot. I had my choice of teams to coach, Sonny, and I chose this team, okay? I chose to coach this team. Not the team you're putting together in your head on the fly because your old man died last week and you're tapping one of your execs.
What did you just say?
I'm sorry, is that supposed to be a secret?
You know, around here, we called my old man, Coach Wheeler. And yes, my father died last week. So next time you refer to his name, next time you say it, at least in front of me, you say it with some goddamn reverence because he earned it. Fair enough?
Hey, sir, man. I don't even think about it.
Sonny Weaver, Jr.
Vontae?
Disappointed you, Mr. Weaver.
Let me tell you something, Vontae, and I don't have a lot of time, so I want you to listen to me carefully, okay? Are you listening?
Yeah.
Don't Twitter. For the love of Jesus, just stop. Delete your profile, get off the web, do not do this to yourself.
I don't know why you care what I do. I can do whatever I want, right?
Of course you can, Vontae, but every GM in the league has now read your tweet, or whatever they call them. And they've all made a mental note that Vontae Mack, however prodigiously talented, is a guy who likes to talk, all right? Who likes to spread rumors, who's more than willing to announce to the world any inane thought that passes through his head. And be it your God-given right or not, Vontae, GMs hate that shit, all right?
We hate it.
You made a mistake, Mr. Weaver.
No, Vontae, I made a deal. And you're going to be a great player in the NFL if you don't manage to sabotage yourself between now and the end of this day.
No. That ball you want to take? That there's a mistake. Callahan's a poser. Yeah.
And what do you know that every scout and coach on earth does not?
I know we got sacked 12 times last year.
No, it was 11. It was 11 times.
Yeah, well, 4 were mine in one game.
Yeah, I remember. I saw your highlight reel. I also remember that he beat you.
Watch it again. Don't watch me. Watch him. Watch me sack him 4 times in one game. Then watch what happens after.
Watch what happens after what?
Just watch.
Jesus Christ. Did you see the person in front of you halfway down the mat? Don't come in. You look like you did it at home.
Yeah! Nice. Morning, boss man.
Tony Bagel, how's my favorite strength coach?
Hey, boss. Did you hear about Brian Drew?
No, what about him?
He came in here yesterday, did a little workout. Guess how much he squatted?
He's not supposed to be squatting.
400. Four bills. I know. And what's even more impressive is his arm. Your star wide receiver, Andre Bell, has been telling me about those secret workouts they've been doing together all winter. You know about those?
Yeah.
Yeah, well, Andre thinks Brian can throw a good 15 yards deeper now. I didn't believe it until I saw what he benched.
What did he bench?
He benched 250, 25 times. Just boom, boom. Translation, Brian Drew's in the best shape of his life.
Word.
Yeah. Boy, come on. Pop it.
Snap it up.
Yeah.
What are we doing on Callahan?
In the weakness department?
Yeah, well, he has a weakness for banging hot chicks on him. I mean, look, he has a whole website dedicated to all the chicks he's banging.
Somebody's got to have something.
He doesn't speak French real good. He got a C-.
And he used to bite his fingernails. Then wait for it. Now he doesn't anymore.
Well, Sonny, really, how many chicks do you think a guy like that sleeps with per week on average? We were thinking like 20, minimum. Minimum.
I say 10. That's 1.5 per day, which makes sense. 2.5 sounds exorbitant.
Listen, speaking as a former college quarterback myself,
Division II,
I say he averages like 3 per day, right? That's 1 in the morning.
I'm trying very hard not to completely lose my shit on all 3 of you right now, but you're not making it easy.
Sonny, so far, he's still the best prospect we've ever seen.
It's easy, Sonny.
We've been looking, Sonny, I swear. Couldn't find anything before him, we can't now. No other team could either. And Callahan can't play football? Nobody.
I get it. But look, nobody's perfect. Everybody has something, even the great ones. Right? He said that Montana was too small, that he'd get hurt, he'd get banged up, but that didn't seem to matter, did it? A lot of people said that Elway was too strong, that he threw too hard. Didn't have touch, but that didn't seem to matter either, did it? Pretty much everyone agreed that Peyton didn't have the arm strength, that he couldn't throw deep, but somehow none of it seemed to matter. You get where I'm going here, guys? We need to find out what Bo Callahan's something is and figure out if it matters or not, right? Figure out if it's something we can live with.
All right, we're on it, Sonny.
All right, Sonny.
Yellow Bo Mark that page. Combine scores were off the charts.
Yeah. Hey, Sonny.
What's up?
Got a question for you, Tom, straight up.
Sure.
Why'd you make the deal?
What?
This morning for Callahan, why did you make that deal?
The same reason you did. It's the best thing for my franchise.
What knock did you find on Callahan?
Son of a bitch.
You all right, Tom? You seem distracted.
Oh, but we didn't find anything on him. I'm sure you guys haven't either.
Come on, I already made the trade. I'm living with that, Tom.
I'm not gonna hold it against you. Just to appreciate it if you could.
Sonny, I gotta go.
Hey, I got your Bill Callahan scouting reports.
Dave, come here. Does that look like me?
What are you doing?
Just...
I need 2 seconds with you in a place that isn't out there.
Okay.
I don't like what's happened between us. Seeing you all day walk the other way, watching you drive away this morning, it's killing me. Look, I know I've disappointed you, and maybe that's not even a strong enough word. If I didn't handle, if I didn't have the right words that you needed to hear, then
look, Sonny, you don't need to do this.
Let me finish. You're supposed to step up, and in the middle of everything that's going on, I didn't get it right. All right, I didn't get all gooey. I didn't jump up and want to know what color to paint the bedroom, blue or pink. And I wish I was one of those kind of guys that know how to make the, the wallpaper line up, the Home Depot dads of the year types that make the rest of us look like assholes.
Those guys are not the reason you look like an asshole.
So I didn't react the perfect way this morning. I shouldn't be penalized for that.
I know that, Sonny. I'm not the mom of the year type either. I don't know how to pack a lunch. I've never changed a diaper. God help me, the one thing I do understand, Sonny, is football. That's me. I'm action-oriented. I'm passionate. I'm a Cleveland girl, and I am football. Maybe more than you. I wasn't born into this game. I had to fight my way in.
I'm sorry to interrupt. I can come back. I'm gonna come back.
What do you need, Rick?
Brian Drew just trashed your office.
What?
I told him you were busy, and he told me to have intercourse with my mother, which, she passed away, so I didn't tell him that. Anyway, he got really mad and started throwing stuff around, and he said he was gonna go down to the locker room.
After all that rehab, you're just going to quit? You're just going to walk away?
Come on, Brian. Don't listen to Coach. Don't leave.
I know what's going on here.
Then just compete with him. Beat him out. Did you trash my office?
Trade me.
Did you just trash my office?
Yeah. I'm upset.
Well, I don't care if you're upset. If you're upset, call your agent. Let him have this conversation. That's what he's there for.
No, Sonny, you're going to talk to me man to man. You owe me that.
I owe you? I drafted you.
Your dad drafted me.
No, Drew, I drafted you. I may have been in San Francisco, but my dad wasn't even looking at you until I told him to. Yeah, and when your knee crapped out and no one wanted you, I still extended your contract. I think I even gave you a raise because I believed in you.
Then why pick Callahan?
You know why.
Then trade me.
I'm going to do what's best for the team.
I've been in this league for 8 seasons. I've been to the playoffs. I know the system the Penn wants to run, and I know I can make it work. I busted my ass this offseason. I set the bar high. I'm in great shape. I feel 10 years younger. I'm telling you, man, I swear to you, the best thing for this team this season is me.
Are you finished?
No.
We'll get finished. And then get back to work. If I trade you, I trade you. If I don't, I don't. Do yourself a favor. Worry about Brian. Don't worry about Bo. And definitely, most absolutely, goddamn importantly, do not bother me with your shit right now, Brian. I'm working here.
Smarter than this. Yeah, women are like.
the Chiefs.
Hey, Pete, what's up?
Well, we're in the market for a QB, and now that you have number one, I was wondering if Brian Drew's available.
I don't know. I haven't made up my mind yet.
Is he healthy?
Well, if you're asking about his knee, it's stronger than ever. He's throwing the ball a good 15 yards farther down the field.
Okay. Just confirming. His agent sent over a tape of Drew working out during the offseason. We like what we see.
He did? That's great.
You seem surprised.
Why would I be surprised?
Okay, Sonny. You don't have to play games with me. What do you want for him? I'm all ears. Let's talk.
Pete, we're still working out some stuff over here. Can I get back to you?
Okay.
Thanks.
Hey, Allie. How you doing? You as jacked as everyone else around here about getting the first pick?
I don't really get jacked. I just manage the cap.
How's a girl like you get in this game anyway?
Law school.
Lawyer. So you don't get excited about anything.
If I do my job and we haven't spent more than $125 million on players by the time the season starts, I get excited.
Mind if I sit down?
I'm busy.
Won't take long. I could use your help. The Browns brought me to Cleveland so that everybody could get one of these.
How is it that the ultimate prize in the most macho sport ever invented is a piece of jewelry?
Yeah, well, be that as it may, I need some draft picks back, okay? Because there's been some pretty foolish moves made by your boyfriend.
My boyfriend.
Please. You have his ear. I don't. Talk to him. It's not about me. It's about the people of Cleveland.
You don't think Callahan's legit?
I think Callahan might be the best prospect in the draft, but I hate rookie quarterbacks. They're stupid and they're scared.
Not the good ones.
We already got a good one. His name's Brian Drew. He can run my offense like a pro. So I'm trying to figure out why I gotta give away the future of the franchise, and then sit around trying to teach some rookie, I don't know, everything. You know, I'm talking shifts, plays, protections, snap counts, alerts, check with me's, double X, jet, ice cream, 36, counter naked, waglet, 16-9, Tennessee free. Know what I'm saying?
Don't patronize me. You know I know what you're saying. I dedicated my life to this sport just like you. And no, I will not speak to Sonny for you.
Bo Ridley Callahan. He's an only child. His mom's a homemaker. His father's a medical malpractice lawyer. He's made some money. Pays his taxes. He's got 3 years left on his mortgage. And the kid's pretty vanilla. Belonged to a few clubs in high school. He had a walk-on role in Damn Yankees. He's on the honor roll from junior high through college. Kept his nose clean. He worked out and, well, you know, he threw a football better than anybody in the great states of Washington or Wisconsin.
But
how do you know there's a but?
Because you're an unoriginal bastard, Ralph. So go on.
But?
But during his final year at Wisconsin, he had a big dinner for his 21st birthday at some restaurant. Locals find out who the dinner's for, and they start filing in. Things get out of control. Manager called the cops, and somebody broke in his office and stole some money. Now, of course, none of this is Bo's fault.
Of course. But?
But the cops came and they took everybody's name regardless. It's 200 people. Standard operating procedure.
But?
Ask me who wasn't there.
Who wasn't there, Ralph?
Any of his teammates. None of his teammates came to the poor guy's birthday party, Sonny.
You're about to be a very happy man. Old Callahan's some of my finest work.
What can you tell me about him?
I can tell you what I just told you, some of my finest work.
Anything else?
You have the tapes. He's the real deal, Sonny. Don't overthink this like your dad would have.
No offense. Look, I love Bo.
My coaches love him. The cheerleaders love him. The fans love him.
Everyone loves him.
Then how come none of his teammates went to his birthday party?
Are you kidding me with this?
Seems relevant.
You want to tear this kid down or what?
No, I just like your take on it. Find it odd that nobody on the team was at their teammate's 21st birthday party.
I don't know, Sonny. What do you think's more plausible? That nobody on an 85-person squad attended a party thrown by the captain? Or could it be that when the cops got to the place and realized that my boys had done nothing wrong, decided not to take down any of the players' names because they didn't want to jam up a bunch of good kids for doing nothing?
Wait a minute.
Your theory seems right. Bo Callahan. Bo Callahan hasn't got any friends. Good luck with the draft today.
Come on, any guys, you're looking pathetic.
Castillo, Antonio Taylor, our first rounder next year, and the year after that.
That's two number ones, a blue chip running back.
I know who they are, Max.
Then you know it's a fair offer.
I'm intrigued.
Good. Let's make a deal.
Well, you gotta give me some time.
Time?
Sonny, time's one thing neither one of us have. Make the deal.
Give me an hour.
We'll give you half that.
What's up?
I just got off the phone with Max Stone.
Yeah? Heard things in Buffalo.
Well, I guess you didn't ask him then when you called him behind my back.
Max is an old friend of mine. He calls me up to congratulate us on the Callahan thing, and I express my opinions on the matter.
He call you or you call him?
Such a crazy day. Who remembers?
Yeah, well, how about try and remember this? I can and I will fire your ass.
Then do it, Sonny.
You actually think I'm going to give up Bo Callahan for Taylor and Castillo? Hmm? Maurice, Castillo...
And draft picks. Okay, don't forget the draft picks, Sonny. You do remember what those are, right?
All right. Look, it's... On the surface, it's not a terrible trade, but why... Why do you think we need to do this?
Because you burned up any currency this team had this morning. Now you have the opportunity to build it back up. And I don't know what your problem is with Maurice. He's a beast.
Looks like Tarzan, plays like Jane.
Your opinion. He plays in my
system. He doesn't block.
I don't need him to block. I need him to run, which he does like a bat out of hell, which takes the pressure off my offense. Okay, I got 52 Tarzans in that locker room. I could use a Jane. You should at least seriously consider what I'm saying.
All right. Give me the numbers on all the guys. We got about 25 minutes to see what's what.
Great.
These are our team reps. This is Wyndham, this is Phil, this is Anthony Zelina.
How do you do?
Sir?
How do you do?
Good.
I'm not sitting here.
Oh, no, of course you're not. You're with the commissioner up in his lounge. Here, let me show you the way. Let's come around here.
He's even better. Actually, too.
Mr. Commissioner?
Hey, Anthony, how you doing?
What are you doing in my line?
You guys sure made tonight a lot more exciting.
Thanks for inviting me in.
Enjoy. Good luck.
Will do.
We talk football? Just football for 30 seconds?
We can always talk football.
There's a deal on the table from Buffalo.
I heard. What's the war room think?
Split. Tim wants me to do it.
But you don't?
I don't.
Why?
Because I know in my heart and my gut that if I make this trade with Buffalo, then I don't get to make a pick this year. All I get back are future draft picks for the guy that Molina brings in to replace me. I've been here 2 years, Allie. 2 years. And I've never gotten a chance to see what a team I put together can do out there. First year, it's my dad's team. Last year, Drew goes down before I can see what we had. Then I get stuck with Penn. I'm still trying to figure out how to work with. This is finally supposed to be my season. I just want the team that I want one time.
So why are you bugging me if you already know?
I'm making mistakes. Remember the 89 Super Bowl?
49ers Bengals. Niners down by 3:20 left in the game. 93-yard winning drive. Taylor beats the weak safety for a 10-yard TD.
Yeah, but before the drive. Joe Montana's in the huddle. Right, and unbelievably, somehow spots the actor John Candy in the stands, points at him, and asks the guys in the huddle, "Hey, isn't that John Candy?" I couldn't believe the balls on him to be that calm in that game at that moment. His guys instantly relax. They march
93 yards.
Montana throws a little slant to Taylor. 49ers win the Super Bowl.
Great game.
It was a great game. No one can stop a ticking clock, but the great ones always find a way to slow it down.
So slow it down, Sonny.
Okay, made a decision. Still Callahan. Let's inform Buffalo that it's a no.
That is beautiful.
Okay, Sonny, we're with you.
Like hell we are. All due respect, Sonny, that is a bonehead move.
Maybe so, but we're back on Callahan. Do me a favor, let's put up the Wisconsin-Ohio State footage.
Yeah, sure thing, Sonny.
We've seen that footage like 2 million times. What are you hoping to find in it that we haven't seen already?
We're just double checking something.
All right,
roll it down the first time Vontae sacks Bo.
All right, here we go.
Man, we should go two blockers like they were ragdolls.
Then Bo walks into a bear hug. Vontae wrapped him up pretty good.
Yeah, Bo's hard to sack. He was one of the least sacked QBs in Division I last year.
Throw the next play.
The next sack?
No, the next play after this one.
Doing?
He got flustered. Didn't wait for the play to develop.
Not Bo's finest moment.
Yeah. Whatever, it's one play. It's down to Vontae's next sack.
Ooh!
Man, that is sick!
He absolutely bull rushed that right tackle. Bo didn't even have a chance.
Yeah, I gotta give it to the kid. He's got a wicked first step.
Let's see what he does on the next play.
Kills. Look at that.
Yeah, look at that. He's frantic.
My favorite thing about rookie QBs, they get frantic when they think they're going to get hit. Although I got to give him credit, barring those two plays, he was brilliant. He threw four TDs, including the last one, to win it.
Take us down to that.
Yeah.
A
looking downfield, staying calm. Sonny, this guy's textbook.
Man, this kid is strong. That's impressive. That's pure Roethlisberger. He's pro ready. End of story.
Take it back. Rewind that back to the start of the play. Just stop right here. What's missing?
Fullback. Wisconsin runs most of their passing plays out of an empty backfield.
No, not what I'm looking at. Try again. Where's Vontae?
You know what, Sonny? I think he got ejected.
He got ejected from the game?
Yeah.
For what?
Yeah, in the third quarter after he stripped the ball from Callahan and scored that TD, he gave the ball to a fan.
Right, right.
When he got flagged for it, he went nuts, touched the refs, and they threw him out.
Right. Bonehead move.
I see that.
Guys, that's his sister. She died about 6 months later.
Who friggin' who? We ain't running an after-school special here. We're running a football team whose offense was ranked 28th in the league last year. And I still need a run back.
To get it. For the record, I didn't do anything. And ton is a relative word.
Play it coy. I like it. Come on, just between two guys, forget the cameras. Who are you going to take? Number one overall.
Well, I think it would be unsportsmanlike. Spoil the surprise.
Anthony Molina, not giving me anything.
Said he wanted to talk to Mr. Weaver. He said it was urgent.
Ralph? Sonny? Allie?
Ralph?
Everybody cozy? Good. Sonny, if you don't mind, I've got something for you in my office. Got a new Callahan story for you.
Not sure I want to hear it. You know, you hung me out to dry pretty good with the last one.
Just talked to Jack Tate in Washington. He said when they found out they had the number 5 pick, first thing they did was send a copy of their playbook to all the guys they were interested in.
Right, we do the same thing.
No, they put a little special twist on it. They tape a $100 bill to the last page.
Why?
So when they're interviewing the guys and they ask them if they read the whole playbook, of course all of them are going to say yes. About half of them, they mention the money, but the other half don't. So when they tell them about the $100 bill, most of the guys get embarrassed. They get flustered. They fess up that they didn't read the whole thing. But ask me what your boy Bo Callahan did.
You know, I really hate playing this game with you.
Ask.
All right, what did Bo Callahan do?
Neither. He said that he'd read it, and then he didn't say anything.
So?
He didn't know about the $100 bill, Sonny. He lied. Never read the whole playbook.
So a lot of guys don't.
Yes, but when they confront him about it, they tell him about the money, he lied again. He said something like, oh yeah, now I remember. Good one, guys. Jack said he is the only guy to tell the lie and then to have the balls to stand and stick up for the lie. Said it was the second strangest response he'd seen to the $100 bill thing. Want to know what the first was?
God damn it, Ralph. Just tell me.
A kid mailed the $100 bill back to them. That kid put it in a card, and he wrote on the card, "Save this for when I win you the Super Bowl."
Nice.
Don't you want to know who that kid was?
No.
It was Brian Drew. It was Brian Drew.
Thinking of making a move?
Talk to me about Vontae Mack.
Why? What do you want to know?
Who cares why?
You thinking of picking him at 15?
He's got potential? No. Friend to friend, what else do I need to know?
Well, he's a great kid.
Come on.
That's what I know.
Quit playing games. You didn't think he was going to fall in the second round, did you? Somebody's going to pick him, Sonny. Tell me why that shouldn't be me.
I'd never tell you how to do your job.
You find something with him?
I didn't say that.
You did not say that.
Good luck tonight.
I'm running.
Any news?
We just got off the phone with Houston. They're at 15. With the Cleveland thing, that might be your best shot.
15?
And I'm not 100% sure about that.
What does that mean, man?
It means it could be a long night. Stay positive. You never know these things.
What's all this?
Both of you, really?
Did you have a fire?
I do not need this today. I really don't.
You look terrible.
Thank you.
You really do.
Thank you, too.
We had the reading of your dad's will. Would you believe he wants his ashes scattered on his field?
The practice field? Here?
Weaver Field, yes. And I'd like to do it as soon as possible.
You can't be serious.
I'm not going to bother anyone. I just want to do it exactly as he asked for it. And he wants you to read this while we're scattering. It's a Gaelic blessing.
Now you're saying you want to do all this now?
Well, all we have to do is walk out on the 50-yard line with you. You read the...
With me?
It's what he wanted.
How the hell would you know what he wanted?
Please don't shout.
Because I was at the will reading, unlike you.
Isn't there an art exhibition in New York that you have to be at or something?
This isn't going to be a long affair. We just go out there, read the prayer, dump the ashes, and go
back. No.
Is everything okay?
Everything's fine. Ellie, this is my ex-wife, Angela.
Hello.
Hi.
Hey, Mark.
How you doing, Amy?
Allie. You know what's Allie.
She's the,
Yeah, that's me.
Get us some coffee, will you, sweetie?
No, that's not her job.
I'll have a green tea. I can get a coffee.
No, stay. Just please stay.
I'd like
a coffee, sorry. Coffee, Mom. You want to spread these goddamn ashes? You do it tomorrow.
No.
I'm serious.
No! Now then, are you going to read this prayer as your father asked you to?
No, I'm not. Not today.
do it myself.
How about some fresh air?
Whoever thought it meant that much to him? Amen. Simple practice filled in his honor. God, he took pride in the various things.
He's your father, Sonny. What was it? Why did you hate him so much?
I didn't hate my father. You know what? Everyone always gives me grief for firing my father.
Well, you did. I was here that day.
It was my mother.
What?
It was my mother. Look, don't get me wrong. I'm the one who fired him, but it was my mother who asked me to do it. My dad's doctors told him that the stress of coaching was going to kill him, so of course he refused to retire. So now I have a choice. The time he has left at home with my mother, or another year on the sidelines, where maybe he drops dead on national television. So what do? I gave it to my mom, and I fired him.
How come you never told me that before?
You know, there's already so many versions of what happened that it's not really something I love talking about.
You never told him. You let him believe that his only son would just fire him. Sonny.
And all I ever wanted to do was just get him a ring. Oh, jeez. What is this?
You want to pay the respects?
Rick, what are you doing?
Someone broke my computer. You know, they keep it used up. I mean, this thing had my entire life on it, and I don't know. Who would do that?
It was me. I threw it against a wall. Yeah, I'm sorry.
Why would you do that?
Look, I lost my head. Okay, I've been stepping on my dick all day. Look, we'll get you a new one. All right, we'll get you a better one. And with all the bells and whistles. Look, you've been a soldier today, all right? You don't deserve this. Okay?
Yeah.
Good.
Good news.
I want to talk to Bo, Chris.
Where's the man you want to speak to? the Browns.
This is Bo.
Hey, Bo, how you doing?
Well, good, Mr. Weaver. Excited to be a part of the NFL, you know?
Good, that's great, Bo. Thrilled to hear that. Listen, I'm going to ask you something. I want you to be absolutely honest with me. You think you can do that?
Yes, sir, anything, Mr. Weaver.
Oh, did your teammates come to your birthday party?
What?
For your 21st birthday party, I'm asking, did your teammates at Wisconsin come to that party or not?
Look, Mr. Weaver, this isn't something I'm really very proud of, sir, but I don't really remember a single thing from that night, sir.
You know what? I don't remember mine either. Thanks, Bill. Talk to you later.
What'd he say?
Take Callahan.
What do you want me to say? He's the winner.
He is. I mean, that's the word, right? He's won everywhere he's been.
I get that. He said the same thing about Ryan Leaf when he was the number two pick in 98. No one said that about Tom Brady when he went 199th. There's no such thing as a sure thing. At the end of the day, all that matters is what you think.
Fascinating twists and turns as the Seattle Seahawks and the Cleveland Browns have engaged in a historic trade just hours before this moment. Here's the commissioner.
NFL Draft. This is an exciting night for our players, our teams, and for you, the fans. The season begins tonight, so let's kick it off. The 2014 NFL Draft is officially open. After an earlier trade with the Seattle Seahawks today, the Cleveland Browns are now on the clock.
Where the hell is Sonny, guys? We're on the clock here.
Yeah, I don't know.
Should be here.
Okay, so the Browns now have 10 minutes on the clock to make a choice, and if they don't do that in that time, the team picking behind them can then jump up and potentially steal away the player the Browns wanted. It's a situation we saw play out in 2003 with the Minnesota Vikings, and it happened again in 2011 with the Baltimore Ravens.
Sonny. Yeah, thank God. Yeah, I was wondering what you were doing. Yeah, it's go time, boss. Okay, yeah, what name do you want the commissioner to say? All right.
Hey, guys, he's here.
Sonny, thank God, where you been? We're on the clock.
Sonny, when are we sending in the ticket?
Yeah.
I already sent the ticket.
You sent the ticket. It's tradition. We all sent.
New tradition, guys. All right, when this team starts winning, we'll go back to that.
And the pick is finally in. It's currently being brandished by some walkie-talkie individual, taking it up to the commissioner's podium. A big, humongous pick for the Cleveland Browns.
Now, to find out whose name is on that card, here is the commissioner, ready to make history in Cleveland.
With the first pick of the 2014 NFL Draft, the Cleveland Browns select Vontae Mack, linebacker, Ohio State.
With the number one overall pick, take Vontae Mack.
Unbelievable to me that Sonny Weaver Jr. would make a deal of this magnitude and come away with this.
Forget about Vontae Mack for a second. They could have had Bo Callahan. He's the surefire slam dunk number one pick. We all knew it coming in here. If I'm Brian Green, current quarterback of the Cleveland Browns, I wouldn't make it.
I'm on my way to Teterboro, and I will literally be in his space in an hour, and he will talk to me then.
I will, sir.
Safe trip, sir.
Thank you, Mom.
Congratulations, Vontae. You're a Cleveland Brown. Car's going to be picking you up in 10 minutes, and we're flying you to Cleveland. You think you can manage that?
We need to get back inside.
What just happened?
This is the NFL draft. These things happen all the time. Now, trust me. These teams, they don't want a quarterback that panics. I need you to come inside now.
Come on.
You picked Fonte.
Three first round picks to get the guy I could have gotten all along. So it's nice to think I was good at this.
Well, that remains to be seen. Sometimes the correct path is the tortured one. Well, it's a gift, Sonny. You see things other people don't see. It's one of the things. It's one of the things I love about.
Excuse me. But you're not going to believe what's happening.
You know, I think back, Dion, and I go back to 1983, and I start thinking about Dan Marino. He was the sixth quarterback taken.
Holy shit.
And 27.
What's going on?
He's dropping.
And then more recently.
What? Picks number two and three are not Bo Callahan. Nobody's picking him.
Green Bay in the mid-20s. Geno Smith.
Just last year.
Wow. Geno Smith drops out of the first round, and there are all kinds of rumors going on right now. Why is this kid dropping? And
everybody's freaking out, Sonny. St. Louis went with Anderson. Miami took Palmer.
Who's picking fourth?
Arizona.
Are they going to take Callahan?
They should, but everybody's off their game. Rams and the Dolphins both went with their expected picks, even though Bo is still available. Everybody's panicking because Callahan's still there.
Jesus, what if he drops to seventh? Seahawks have seven. What if they ended up with Callahan?
Tom Michaels is the GM of the decade. I'm going to the can. Grow up.
Okay, Denver has five. Jacksonville has six.
If Denver's not going to take Callahan, they got Herod. He's an all-pro, so if Arizona balks, if Jacksonville's all over him.
Unless they balk, too.
And our friend Tom Michaels grabs him at seven. Shit!
They have that kid GM down in Jacksonville. What is his name?
Jeff Carson?
Rookie. Right, Jeff Carson.
About this thing. What's wrong with Callahan?
Nothing. We like Vontae better.
The Rams took my pick. Everything's out of whack.
Well, you still have time.
We don't know. I'll
look. Arizona is picking right now.
You're right. Hold on.
With the fourth pick of the 2014 NFL Draft, the Arizona Cardinals select Robert Starks, quarterback from Georgia Tech.
Come on.
Wow, Arizona went corner.
Shit, Starks was my backup.
Tough break, but hey, Callahan's still in play. Who's picking fifth?
The Broncos, and they're not picking Callahan. They got Matt Herod. They don't need him.
Yeah, I think you're right. I think they're going to go with that big kid out of Oregon, Dearborn, left tackle. Well, congratulations, Jeff. You looks like you got yourself Bo Callahan, the quarterback of the Jacksonville Jaguars.
You got to be straight with me.
About what?
What's wrong with Callahan? Why is everyone passing on him? Why did you pass on him?
I told you, we like Vontae better.
Damn it, Sonny, I'm about to be on the clock here. Please. What's wrong with Callahan?
Can I be frank with you?
Yes.
I think he's a bust.
What? How? Why?
I don't know. Gut feeling. To be honest, Jeff, it's a character thing for me. But look, I have other needs. So if you want to make a trade for six, I can make that happen right now.
You want six? Who are you taking?
I can't tell you that, Jeff. The question is, do you want to make a trade? Because if you're not sold on Callahan, you can still come out of here with a handful of draft picks. You look like a seasoned pro.
And everybody wonders what you're up to next year.
I don't know. I don't know, Sonny.
Look, Jeff. Every year, someone comes out of this looking like a donkey.
Can you hear me?
Yeah.
Good, because tomorrow I got a feeling it could be you if you don't make this deal. Look, everyone else Everyone else has a reason to pass on Bo Callahan. You don't. Give me six. Give me six and I'll give you our second round pick this year and our second rounder next year.
What?
Oh, that sounds awesome, Sonny. What am I, a jerk?
I'm just spitballing here, Jeff.
Two number twos for the sixth overall. I'm not an idiot.
I give you ones, but I already dealt them.
Well, you're going to have to do better than that. Jesus, that's a flop.
I know Denver hasn't picked yet, but they will any second, all right?
Sit, Sonny. I need more. Tell me. What is the very best that you can do?
Okay. And final offer. Take our number two pick this year, next year, and the next year after that. That's 3 years of number two picks.
Four. I want your next four number twos.
Nah, Jeff, I'm not going to do that. Stay with me on planet Earth here, all right? You know what I just offered you is fair.
So, 3 years of second rounders.
That's right, for your pick right now. And you and your guys can regroup, figure yourselves out, and relax. This is a good deal, Jeff. This is a good deal for both of us.
Deal.
Good, Jeff. You did good. Call it in. Call it in.
Hey, this is Marks.
Yes, okay. Cleveland, Cleveland,
Jacksonville.
Okay, give it to me.
Okay, somebody give me Tom Michaels on the phone.
Tell me you didn't just do that, Sonny.
Michaels, Tom Michaels.
Wait, are we on the clock?
Tell me you didn't just do that.
We just got the number six pick, and no, we are not on the clock. Denver is on the clock.
Okay, so we got six. Who are we picking at six? Yeah. Can you get Mark on the phone now?
Okay. Let me get this straight. In the span of one day, you have managed to burn through 3 years worth of number one and number two picks. Is that correct?
Yeah.
I quit, Sonny.
Don't quit.
I can't coach a team that doesn't have a future, Sonny. That's the way it works.
I got Tom Michaels on the line.
Sonny, are we trading six?
Well, everyone, please just shut up. People, please, can I have a moment of goddamn silence while I do my job here, okay? Don't quit. Just let me do my job here. Just let me do this. Don't quit now. If by the end of the night you still want to quit, then quit. Just see what I do from here.
Your show, Sonny.
Tom Michaels is holding.
You son of a bitch! Anthony, I need 5 minutes, all right? 5 minutes, and then you can fire me.
Sonny,
okay?
You are a dead man.
Mr. Molina, look at me. Just give him a minute. He knows what he's doing.
Tom, it's Sonny.
Jesus, Mary and whatnot.
Well, I owe you a thank you, Weaver.
Thank you.
Jacksonville's on the clock, and I'm one more crazy shit show from insanity. Can you imagine scoring three first-round picks and Bo Callahan? Lord God, let that infant John Carson screw this up.
It's Jeff Carson, Tom, and he doesn't have a pick. I do.
What?
I just made a trade with Jacksonville. I'm on the clock. It's me.
Bullshit.
The Jacksonville Jaguars have made a trade. The Cleveland Browns now have the sixth pick and are on the clock.
Sonny, what'd you get?
No time for that. I'm on the clock. I'm going to pick Bo, Tom, unless you want him more. And if so, let's make a deal.
We still have Bo Callahan?
What the hell's going on, Sonny?
Everyone thinks there's something wrong with a kid, but you don't. You've done your due diligence. You're about to pull off the move of the century, but you need my pick to do it, so make me an offer.
You're going rogue. You're going renegade.
Yeah, that's right. That's exactly right. I could have gotten Vontae at seven, but instead I trade up with you just so I can get him at one. Jesus Christ. You were right about me, Tom. I am a crazy man, so come on, take advantage of it. What are you waiting for? Make me a deal, Tom, at six. You get your boy Wonder.
What do you want?
I want my number ones back, all of them.
Give them back.
Because at the end of the day, no one's the wiser. Tom, you haven't lost anything, and you get the quarterback Messiah you've always wanted for $7 million less.
Can't do it. I look like an idiot, like I panicked.
You take them. You obviously don't want to. I'll stick with my draft picks.
Yeah, but you want them, Tom, don't you? Seahawk fans want a hero, and you denied him.
Not that bad.
Don't lie to me. I checked all the Seahawk fan blogs and chat rooms. They're all calling for your head. Ever since you traded away Callahan, the barbarians are at the gate.
I don't care about that.
Yeah, you do. You and I both know it. I have the golden ticket now, Tom, and if I give it to you, you get to save Seahawk football in Seattle.
How about give you number two picks?
No. Mm-mm-mm-mm. No, I want my picks back, all of them. I want all 3 years of this team's future back.
That's not fair.
Well, you want to cry about it, Tom, or you want to make a little magic before the clock runs out on both of us?
$7 million cheaper solves our salary cap problem. We still need the fans a bit more.
Okay, screw it. No more offer. It's off the table, Tom. I'm taking Callahan.
Whoa, no. Hey, wait. All right, you have a deal.
Give me your picks. We have a deal.
What else do we need?
Special teams. Putney.
Yeah,
get
Putney. Yeah, save the Putney. Yeah. Hello? Sonny?
I'm sorry, that deal's now off the table.
What?
We live in a different world than we did just 30 seconds ago.
What? What do you want now?
I want my picks back. And I want David Putney. I need a punt returner.
Where the hell did that come from?
It doesn't matter. I want all my picks back, and I want David goddamn Putney just because I feel like it.
You're out of your mind.
Yeah, I am. Haven't I proved that already? You make this deal right now, Tom, and you get Bo Callahan. Say it with me. You get Bo. Come on, Tom, say it with me, you pancake eating motherfucker.
All right. Deal.
Great. You're welcome. You found the trick. God damn it, I love this job.
Hold on, looks like Cleveland's making another trade.
We got a trade.
Okay, this means we're picking next, all right? Back at 7, where are we starting? Tom's going to take Bo, so who do we got?
Ray Jennings.
We take Ray Jennings.
That's right. Cleveland royalty. Haven't I been telling everybody that that's what we need, a running back? Still want to quit, Coach? Does this sound like a team that you want to coach? Because the Browns are ready to roll. We just need the right man at the wheel.
I can coach this team.
I know you can. Why don't you give Ray Jennings a call? Ask him if he wants to be a Brown. And tell him to pack his bags so he can join us at our party.
My pleasure, boss.
You got some silly balls, Sonny. Congratulations.
After a trade with the Cleveland Browns, with the 6th pick of the 2014 NFL Draft, the Seattle Seahawks select Bo Callahan, quarterback.
University of Wisconsin.
Hello? Hold on. Hello?
Ray.
Coach Penn of the Cleveland Browns.
Hey, Coach.
How would you like to play for your pops' old team?
Gonna be around.
General Manager Sonny Weaver Jr. took one pick in the first round, the number 7 pick. He sprinkled it with fairy dust, wished upon a star, and somehow he turned it into not one, not two, but 3 potentially impactful players for his team next year. One pick!
He took a chance. He went with his gut. He took his guys. Make no mistake about it, the Cleveland Browns are his team now for sure.
This is the draft day Browns fans were waiting for. Sonny Weaver Jr.
Hold it off.
When you were like, I want all my picks back, and I want David goddamn Plucky because I feel like it. Like, how did you come up with that?
I was pissed.
Here, look at who we have right
now. Right, let me break it down. Monte Mack, the guy who plays with more passion and inspiration than anyone in college football. He's a Brown. Ray Jennings, the running back the Browns have needed for years. A return man to help out on special teams. And Riz, just like we wanted, Brian Drew, back at quarterback, where he belongs. I don't even want to hear about Bo Callahan. If he thinks Callahan's a bust, who am I going to argue with him?
He turned nothing into a big-time something.
Smile for the cameras, Coach.
This is a day for Cleveland to celebrate.
We had a great day!
Super Bowl! Super Bowl! Super Bowl! Super Bowl! Super Bowl!
Mom?
There you are.
You okay?
Yeah, it was just so noisy downstairs. I had to get a few minutes of quiet.
We're taking off. You sure you're gonna be okay?
I think your dad would have been very happy to come to team with this.
I think so, too. Thank you. Look, we gotta go.
Of course. It's a long day. Bye, Allie.
Good night, Barb.
Hey, Mom. We're gonna have a baby. I'm gonna be a grandma. Wow.
That was big.
But I will.
teeth and a blade in your back. What you know about hope? What you know about that? Write off as criminal, a place to cast a stone. On and on, we carry on when what is not enough. We are the ones who were born to rise. We are the ones with the fire inside. I go to war with the brothers I trust, and there ain't no stopping us. There ain't no stopping us. There ain't no stopping us. What you know about standing up when the odds get stacked? Time stands still, ain't no turning back when everything you're worth is under attack. What you know about heart? What you know about that? Ride off as criminal, a place to cast a stone. On and on, we carry on when what is not enough. There ain't no stopping us, there ain't no stopping us. We were born to rise. Ain't no stopping us, no stopping us. We were born to rise. Ain't no stopping us, no stopping us. Thank you.